Hi everyone, it's Casey Williams. You know, I learned a few years ago that the Ford Motor Company was selling Volvo to China's Geely. I really had some questions. I mean, up to that point, Geely had really only built some low-end, cheaply assembled compact cars. And for them to take on a global automaker like Volvo and do well with that seemed like a pretty big bite. But I gotta tell you, the engineers in Sweden clearly had their way with this new Volvo XC90. It's not only a really good Volvo, it's a really good car, period. Up in the upper class of the crossovers and SUVs in the luxury market. So let's go take a look at it and find out why it's so much improved and why it really is mentioned along with the very best SUVs in the world. Well, if there's any doubt that Geely was going to mess up Volvo, just take a look at this styling. It's spot on. It looks like a Volvo XC90, but it looks like something that maybe the Swedish Mafia might drive around to. Look at the front. Nice big chrome grille, the Volvo logo right in the middle. You immediately know who makes it. The Thor's hammer signature lighting that they put on the new vehicles, including the new S90. Again, looks nice. All LED lighting for the headlamps. Again, very classy, very elegant. Looks very expensive as well. Come around the side. Again, our black paint looks very mafia-esque. 20-inch alloy wheels. And being Volvo, they don't go overboard with the chrome. Just enough to give it a little bit of jewelry. Some chrome detailing around the windows, a little around the door handles, and down below on the lower bodies. Again, just to give it a little bit of elegance, a little bit extra. You can also tell it's a Volvo from the strong shoulder lines. Again, that's the trademark design cue for them for 50 years or more. Again, you know it's an XC90. And come around the back, again, signature lighting here. Comes up into the pillar. Kind of the C shape as well that you see in the sedans now. Power rear hatch. And with the third row folded down, you've got two extra seats here in the third row. You have quite a bit of luggage space as well. A little bit of underfloor storage. And then the second row also goes all the way forward. So you can get a lot of stuff in here if you need to. Well, if you're expecting to see a big V6 or V8 engine when I lift the hood, you're going to be sadly mistaken. But don't get too upset, because what is here is actually a really good engine. So it's a 2-liter four-cylinder engine and delivers 316 horsepower. Now it does that because it's both turbocharged and supercharged. It's a unique engine for Volvo. So supercharged, so you get that nice low-end torque off the line. Turbocharged, so you get that extra, kind of the deep lung feeling out on the highway. Plenty of power in the car. It's connected to an 8-speed automatic transmission. It's all-wheel drive. It does 0-60 in about 7 seconds, tops out around 130 miles per hour. So plenty quick enough for what this car is. Looking at gas mileage, talk about 20 miles per gallon in the city, 25 miles per gallon on the highway. That's not super efficient for a midsize crossover, but with over 300 horsepower and three rows of seats, that's not bad. And they're also going to have a plug-in hybrid version of this car. So if you want something that's even faster than this one, with much better fuel economy, look for that one as well. So I get in the car last week when it arrives, and I open up the doors, and immediately I know it's a beautiful car. And I'd seen the photo, so I knew it. I mean, it's got a very nice Scandinavian design with the wood here in the console, wood on the dash, kind of the stitched effect here as well. Again, feels very expensive. I love the seats as well. So I get in, and now I want to turn the car on. Well, there's no push button. And you actually have these little etched knobs here on the center console. So you turn it. Works just beautifully. Then the next thing I want to do is, I know the car's got auto start stop, and I'm trying to look for that button. I can't find it. I want to get my phone connected, get to the menu for that. Can't find that either. So the main menu here, and it's all swipe screen, I'll show you in a second. So you got navigation, your media, I've got the iPod connected now, phone, and you can change how you want the speaker sounds to be. So it takes me a few seconds, but then I realize, swipe it. Here's all the stuff you need for audio. Here's the sound experience, you can change it here. Studio sound, individual. I've got it on concert hall again, I've got a live concert on the radio right now. Works out very nice. It takes me back. You've got all your apps down below. It works out very, very nice there. So after I figure that out, you can connect your Bluetooth if you want to there. Come back. This menu I love. And I started to complain again, because there's no way to turn off all the crash avoidance systems. Sometimes they bother you in traffic when you're close to stoplights. But Volvo has included one screen, one menu, everything you need. So you got the lane keep assist here, your parking assist, your backing sensors, cross traffic alert. You've got a forward collision warning system, and this has pedestrian and cycling detection on it. This is the auto start stop, which absolutely drives me nuts, but it does help save gas mileage because it pauses the engine at stop. So I almost always turn that off, and that's probably bad. And then the car's got some other systems here. And again, you just kind of pick these by menu. If it's off, it's off, and it's green, it's activated. So you've got a parallel parking system here, guides the car in. It's also got a park out button, so it'll help guide the car back out semi-autonomously. It's got heads-up display. You can adjust all that here very easily. Your blind spot warning gives you roadside information, the heads-up display. It's got adaptive cruise control, all that's connected here. So again, all the safety gear. Here, one big menu, don't define anything. It's great. Heated steering wheel, heated seats, ventilated seats if you need them. It's also got massagers on the seats. The back seat has its own touch screen here. Turn the heat on, you can adjust the fan speed here. Very easy to use. So again, I think a lot of car companies do these touch screens, swipe screens, and they don't work out very well. I think Volvo's actually made ones very simple. Easy access to information, it's great. The one thing I love about this car is it has a Bowers & Wilkins audio system in it. And I've been listening to, I've got Susan Boyle in here now with a live concert, listening to Elvis, several others. It is by far the best audio system I've ever listened to in a car. And I've listened to a lot of audio systems in cars, but it's just great. And I just think what Volvo's done is they've really kept the things that are Volvo. It feels very safe, it's not overdone, but it feels very high tech, very current, and it's just a very elegant place to be. Well, clearly we didn't have to worry about Volvo being owned by Geely. All they've done is made a much better Volvo. So the car is very luxurious, it's comfortable, it's elegant, I love the sound system in it, and it's got plenty of power. So all in, a very good car. Well, they've done a very smart thing with this vehicle as well. With a price point starting just under $46,000, they're still right there with their traditional Volvo owner. But this one at $72,805 fully loaded puts against some very high-end cars. Talking about the Range Rover Sport, the Mercedes GLE, the BMW X5. Again, very good company for a car from Volvo. They've done a very good job of elevating their standard without losing anything that was there before. So next week we have another fun car. Until then, storm forward.